Hello and welcome to Youth Work Toolbox with me, Tony Brown, and this is 1000 Do's and Don'ts When Working with Young People, episode number 4. So, you want to develop a website for your organisation that's more engaging for young people? Do involve young people in the process from the beginning, as they probably know more about web development, web design, functions and features than you actually realise. Don't underestimate the valuable contributions a group of college students can bring to the project. In some cases, they are more innovative and at the cutting edge than some professionals who will charge you an arm and a leg for their services. Plus, they'll get a great buzz from seeing their work come to life in the real world. Do find out what websites your target audience use on a daily and weekly basis, and find out why they use them and what they like about them. Don't try to replicate and compete with the most popular sites that your target audience uses. Believe me, they're not going to leave YouTube to start watching videos on your website. Do survey young people within your target audience to find out what are the top 5 functions the website must have. Don't just ask them what functions should the site have. Rather, ask should the site have function X or function Y. This will help you to gauge which function they prefer over another. Do incorporate and make best use of the most appropriate social media platforms relevant to your target audience. If they're not using Facebook, don't incorporate Facebook. If they're using Pinterest and Instagram, then incorporate those. Don't assume that everyone in your organisation is going to be supportive of the project. Some people are still to recognise the value of being visible and relevant online. Do understand the difference between a web designer and a web developer before you hire anybody. The designer makes a site look nice. The developer makes a site work. Don't just settle for the corporate look and feel your in-house design service suggests. Do challenge and push back on your in-house ICT and design departments. They probably need to be pulled out of their comfort zones anyway. Don't hire a scammy, money-hungry, specialist youth design agency who are more interested in how much budget do you have rather than what would you like to achieve. Do hire a local designer stroke developer who's able to come in and support the process throughout. Don't get caught up with how fancy the design looks. Sometimes less is more and simple is more effective. Just look at Google's homepage. Do be very clear on why you're developing the site and what you want the site to do. This reduces wasted time, effort, and money later down the line. Don't be scared to give young people some ownership of the site. User-generated content is probably the most valuable and popular content on the internet. Do produce a mock-up of your homepage design, print it off, and request some feedback from everyone involved in the process. Don't use too much text on your website. Young people, in fact most people, don't like to have to read big blocks of text on a webpage. Instead, make best use of images, videos, and infographics. Do enjoy the process. You will hit loads of barriers, but you will learn a ton of new things throughout the process. So much, in fact, that one day you might even record a do's and don'ts video about it. Don't wait for everything to be perfect before you launch the site. Just get it to a point where the main features work and you can begin to get user feedback. Then you can add features along the way. So that's it. 1000 do's and don'ts when working with young people. 10 do's and 10 don'ts when developing a website for your organisation to engage with young people. I'm Tony Brown, this is Youth Work Toolbox. I will see you in episode number 5. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe. I think I prefer this setup. The lighting's better. It's more natural. My face doesn't shine as much.